We read this morning from Joshua 14, as from verse 6. Now the people of Judah approached Joshua at Gilgal, and Caleb, son of Jephunneh the Kenizzite, said to him, "You know what the Lord said to Moses, the man of God, at Kadesh Barnea about you and me. I was 40 years old when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from Kadesh Barnea to explore the land, and I brought him back a report according to my convictions. But my fellow Israelites who went up with me made the hearts of the people melt in fear. I, however, followed the Lord my God wholeheartedly. So on that day Moses swore to me, 'The land on which your feet have walked will be your inheritance and that of your children forever, because you have followed the Lord my God wholeheartedly.' Now then, just as the Lord promised, he has kept me alive for 45 years since the time he said this to Moses, while Israel moved away about in the wilderness. So here I am today, 85 years old. I am still as strong today as the day Moses sent me out. I'm just as vigorous to go out to battle now as I was then. Now give me this hill country that the Lord promised me that day. You yourself heard then that the Anakites were there, and their cities were large and fortified. But the Lord helping me, I will drive them out just as he said." Then Joshua blessed Caleb, son of Jephunneh, and gave him Hebron as his inheritance. So Hebron has belonged to Caleb, son of Jephunneh the Kenizzite, ever since, because he followed the Lord, the God of Israel, wholeheartedly. Hebron used to be called Kiryat Arba, after Arba, who was the greatest man among the Anakites. Then the land had rest from war. Our text verse is verse 9. "So on that day Moses swore to me, 'The land on which your feet have walked will be your inheritance and that of your children forever, because you have followed the Lord my God wholeheartedly.'" 45 years before this event, the Lord said to Moses that he must send some men to explore the land of Canaan, which he was giving to the Israelites. Moses then sent 12 leaders, including Caleb and Joshua. These spies scouted the land for 40 days and then returned to Moses. They reported to Moses and the Israelites and showed them the fruit of the land. They said, "We went into the land to which you sent us, and it does flow with milk and honey. Here is its fruit. But the people who live there are powerful, and the cities are fortified and very large. We even saw descendants of Anak there." These descendants were very tall people, giants, and the spies said that they felt like grasshoppers in their own eyes. They told Moses, "We can't attack those people, they are stronger than we are." Numbers 13 verse 27-28. Caleb, however, silenced the people before Moses and said, "We should go up and take possession of the land, for we can certainly do it." Numbers 13 verse 30. The bad report of the other 10 spies scared the Israelites so much that they wanted to return to Egypt, where they were slaves. They lost all faith in the Lord who had led them from Egypt, and they grumbled to Moses and the Lord. The spies, Caleb and Joshua, tore their clothes and told the Israelites not to be afraid, because the Lord was with them and that he would give them the promised land. But the Israelites talked about stoning these two spies. The Lord became very angry with the Israelites for their lack of belief and trust in him. He announced that all the Israelites of 20 years old or more would die because they grumbled against him. Only Caleb and Joshua would not die. The Israelites would remain in the wilderness for 40 years, 1 year for each day the spies explored Canaan. Their bodies would fall in the wilderness. Caleb was the optimistic spy. He believed Israel could conquer Canaan. That is why God said, "But because my servant Caleb has a different spirit and follows me wholeheartedly, I will bring him into the land he went to, and his descendants will inherit it." God made three promises: a long life, at least another 40 years, entry into Canaan, and that his and his descendants would enter the land where he walked. Caleb outlived the doubters. The Lord struck down the 10 spies who doubted him with a plague. Only Caleb and Joshua survived. God rewarded their faith and positive action, their following of him with their whole hearts. God always rewards faith and action that goes beyond mere words, action that shows a sure knowledge and a steadfast trust in him. When Caleb was 85 years old, the people of Judah came with him to Joshua. He spoke to Joshua and reminded him of what the Lord had said 45 years previously. He also reminded Joshua that Moses had sworn to him, "The land on which your feet have walked will be your inheritance and that of your children forever, because you have followed the Lord my God wholeheartedly." Joshua 14 verse 9. Let us consider God in Caleb's life. First, God kept him alive. Second, God gave him strength. And third, God gave him faith. First then, God kept Caleb alive. He said to Joshua, "Now then, just as the Lord promised, he has kept me alive for 45 years since the time he said this to Moses, while Israel moved about in the wilderness. So here I am today, 85 years old." God had already fulfilled two of the three promises to Caleb: a long life of 85 years, and that he entered Canaan. God had kept him alive in the wilderness during the dangers and the fatigues of that march of 45 years, or 40 years and another 5 years of war. God kept him alive even though that whole generation of Israel, except himself and Joshua, had died in the wilderness. That is why he could exclaim, "So here I am today, 85 years old. I am now in Canaan." Not only did Caleb acknowledge that the Lord had kept him alive, but also that the Lord had kept his promises. He demonstrated what true faith is. It is a certain, sure knowledge that what God says is true, and an assured confidence in that truth. A certain knowledge and an assured confidence. God has kept us alive. His power protects us from death, and his bounty supports and comforts us. When we see so many people die among us, we should thank God more and more for sparing our lives. He has a lifelong purpose for each one of us. He freely gives you and me remission of sin, everlasting righteousness and salvation. That is his purpose for you. The Holy Spirit works this faith, the gospel, in your heart, that God does this merely of grace, only for the sake of Christ's merits. At the age of 40, Caleb believed that God would enable Israel to conquer Canaan. God did not just give Caleb faith in him and then left him on his own. No, the Holy Spirit continually worked in Caleb's heart. God did lead the Israelites into Canaan. God did give Caleb and Joshua long lives, while everyone else around them of their generation had died in the desert. Now we could openly declare that the Lord had kept him alive and brought him into Canaan, and that the Lord would give him his inheritance, which is the third promise. The Holy Spirit continually worked in our hearts too and kept us alive. The Holy Spirit worked with you, convinced you of sin and salvation, and that the Lord remained faithful to you in all the good moments and bad moments, in problems, in joy, and in sadness, and in challenges. Too many people shrink from adventures in faith because of their age. Don't let advancing years keep you from life's greatest adventures. The Lord is faithful. He does what he promises. Take him on his word, just as Caleb took him on his word when he said to the Israelites, "Do not be afraid of the people of the land, because we will devour them. Their protection is gone, but the Lord is with us. Do not be afraid of them." Numbers 14, verse 9. Do not be afraid of life's challenges and problems. Trust in God. But secondly, God gave Caleb the strength. At 85, Caleb refused to believe he was too weak to succeed. He says, "So here I am today, 85 years old. I'm still as strong today as the day Moses sent me out. I am just as vigorous to go out to battle now as I was then." Verse 11. He focused on strength rather than weakness. Some older people think only of their ailments. Caleb got his strength from the Lord, and he knew it. The Lord has kept him alive for the past 45 years. Can you hear it from his words? "So here I am today, 85 years old." At 85, Caleb thought of the joy of adventure, the joy of life, the joy of God in his life. Caleb viewed his strength as sufficient for whatever was ahead. He said he was as strong at 85 as at 40. When he was 40 years old, he was strong enough to go to war expecting victory because he knew that the Lord was with him. Now at 85, Caleb believed that the Lord would still help him here in this hill country. He was ready for one more fight. He reminded Joshua that Joshua himself heard 45 years ago that the Anakites were in this hill country, and that their cities were large and fortified. Verse 12. This was the place from where the spies took their report to Moses. This was where the spies met the sons of Anak, the giants who filled them with fear. Numbers 13, verse 22. This place was called Hebron, and in verse 15 we read that Hebron used to be called Kiriath Arba, after Arba, who was the greatest man among the Anakites. So he must have been a super giant among the giants. Hebron was the most difficult place to conquer. That did not frighten Caleb. The Lord had promised him that land, and Caleb believed that the Lord would give it to him. He did not rely on his own strength or courage, but he said, "The Lord helping me, I will drive them out just as he said." Verse 12. He built his hope on God. Do you view your strength as sufficient for whatever lies ahead for you? You can only do so if you seek your strength from the Lord. If you think about yourself, you will focus only on your frailties, your pains and aches. However, if you think of the Lord and his grace, you will focus on your strength. The Apostle Paul said, "For when I'm weak, then I'm strong." 2 Corinthians 12, verse 10. And he also said, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness." 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9. When the Lord delivered David from the hands of his enemies and from Saul, he sang, "It is God who arms me with strength and keeps my way secure." Psalm 18, verse 32. Isaiah wrote, "Surely God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. The Lord himself is my strength and my defense. He has become my salvation." Isaiah 12, verse 2. Christ provides the strength for the day. The Apostle Paul knew it, what it meant to be in need and what it was to have plenty. He learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. He said, "I can do all this through him who gives me strength." Philippians 4, verse 12 and 13. Through Christ, God gives you strength for the day. Seek your help from the Lord. Put your trust in the Lord, just as Caleb put his trust and faith in the Lord. Humbly pray for the love of God and entrust your life in his hands, even in the greatest difficulties. Thirdly, God gave Caleb faith. Caleb said to Joshua, "Now give me this hill country. The Lord promised me that day." Verse 12. In faith, Caleb took up the Lord on his promise. The Lord has made a promise, and Caleb knew that the Lord would deliver on his promise. He would do so in the same way that he delivered on his promise to deliver the Israelites from Egypt. The Lord delivered on his promise to lead the nation into Canaan. The Lord delivered on his promise to give Caleb and Joshua a long life. Caleb experienced God's fulfillment of his promises firsthand. That is why he could confidently say, "Now give me this hill country that the Lord promised me that day." In faith, we may also take up the Lord on his promises. The Bible is full of promises. Jesus promised eternal life for those who believe in him. He promised to forgive your sins, to give you everlasting righteousness and salvation. This does not only apply to others. Jesus made this promise to you and to me. He promised to give his Holy Spirit to everyone who prays for it. Appropriate these promises for yourself in faith and in trust of the Lord. Pray the Lord to strengthen your faith in him. What can one more earnestly desire than God's promises? How can one more confidently expect that God would grant his promises? God gave Caleb his faith. The Bible describes Caleb here as the Kenizzite, verse 14. The Kenizzites originally did not belong to the nation of Israel, the descendants of Jacob, who was later called Israel. The Kenizzites descended from Esau through Kenaz. We read about that in Genesis 15, verse 19, and several other places. It seems that Caleb, one of the most faithful to God of his time, was just one generation away from a family that did not belong to the nation of Israel. Through grace, however, Caleb became an Israelite, a member of the nation elected by God. God equipped him to follow him wholeheartedly. Through grace, God also has equipped us for what he wants us to do. Follow him with all your heart, and he will bless you. Joshua blessed Caleb, son of Jephunneh, the Kenizzite, and gave him Hebron as his inheritance. We read that in verse 14. The Bible again emphasizes that Caleb was the Kenizzite, a person who originally was not part of the nation of Israel. Through divine grace, Caleb received his inheritance. So do we receive our eternal inheritance through divine grace, through the offering of Jesus Christ on the cross. Through Jesus, you and I are part of God's nation on earth. He has elected us to be his children. Note what the word of God says in verse 14. Caleb and his heirs received Hebron as inheritance because he followed the Lord, the God of Israel, wholeheartedly. Let us follow the Lord, the God of Israel, with all our hearts. Doing God's will is life's greatest adventure. The adventure begins with salvation by grace. The Apostle Paul wrote to the Ephesians, "For it is by grace you have been saved, through faith. And this is not from yourselves, it is a gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do." Ephesians 2, verse 8 to 9. God has created adventures, great adventures, planned for us who believe. Have you surrendered your life to God through Christ? Amen.